Everyone, it's Monica. So I'm back to share another project. This one is not a card. So my friend Julie, the paper bag lady here on YouTube, her birthday was back in March. So I decided, along with buying her a gift, that I would be altering something for her. So I decided to alter the letter J. I have a tendency to alter the letter of all my friends' names, usually at some point. I'll send it to them. So this was her turn. So here are a couple of the items that I used. The rest I will go through as I'm showing the letter. I can point out where everything is. So the main things, I used this antique gold Americana paint, and I diluted it and I lightened it up with a whole bunch of gesso. I wanted a very light color on my letter. I used the Tim Holtz, well, Ranger, I should say, not Tim Holtz, Ranger's texture paste. I use the ink gold in brown gold. I use these doilies that I actually got from the paper bag lady. I used this paper tray ink border as well on the letter. And I also use the Tim Holtz measured stencil. Alrighty, I think that's it for the main stuff. Let me move this off to the side. To adhere a lot of the things, I used glossy accents and as well as Fabri-Tac. I think I used some hot glue as well. Yeah, I did. I also used a whole bunch of clear glass bling. So let me go ahead and bring the letter in. So here is the letter. So first I'll show the back because I didn't cover it. That way you can see the texture. So I went ahead and I used the measured stencil along the letter. I did it on both front and back. And on this one, I also did it on the side. For the inside here, instead of using the stencil, just because of where it was, I just decided to use that border strip and I glued it all the way around to the very end to give the inside some texture. Once all that was done, I gessoed it, and then I painted it with the mixture of mostly gesso with just a little bit of the antique gold, and I went all over the letter. Once that was dry, I went to town with my Inca gold. As you can see, it's everywhere. I smeared it all over. Oh, I lied. Before I did all of that, after I did the stenciling, before I gessoed it, I adhered a whole bunch of metal gears onto it for added texture. Then I gessoed it and added and painted it and then did the Inca gold. Once all that was done, I did go back and add some additional gears in copper and bronze that I did nothing to. I just left them in their metal state. As you can see here, I layered three different gears here. I just have this little one on top of that one, two additional here. There's one up here. I did put some smaller ones right here. I didn't add any additional to the back. Since this is most likely going to be up against the wall, it wasn't really going to be seen. I didn't feel the need to add more to it, but I did want to go ahead and stencil and finish the back as well. So once that was done, I also added this Prima clock. This is from their trinkets, and I believe this is the larger out of the two in the package. I added a couple of more gears before I adhered everything down. Once that was done, and I adhered it all down with glossy accents. Once that was all done, I sealed it with a spray sealer. Since the Inca gold is water-based and it does react with water, I wanted to go ahead and make sure and seal that. So, and that also helped protect some of the metal gears that you had out in case they got wet. Once that was done, I took a whole bunch of the doilies. I have three different doilies, one up here, one in the middle, and one down here, and put them on the base. And then after that, I just went to town with the different I Am Roses and Wild Orchid Crafts. The leaves are the large maple leaves from I Am Roses. These are, I forgot what these are called, but these are from I Am Roses. We have a little carnation from Wild Orchid Crafts. We have the apple blossoms all tucked in here. Oh, and I forgot to mention what sprays I used for this. Let's see. Do I still have them out? I can grab them real quick. Okay. So for the colors of the flowers, I got, for these ones, I used my Marion Smith in the Color Lab. I used the 24K. Then for these orangey ones, I used the California Poppy Gold. For this yellow one here, I used Ice Primrose Yellow. Then for this yellow one, I used the Shimmers Vibes and the Eggnoggin. So as I was tucking all of those flowers in, I also added additional gears to the sides to tuck in between all the flowers. You got some more there. This is a Prima bulb that says Live. What else? In between all of the gears, I went ahead and I added clear flatback rhinestones. I use, let's see, what sizes did I use? It looks like I used like SS12s. SS12s, that one looks like an SS20, another SS20 tucked in here. Yeah, it looks like I used SS20 and SS12s. So Julie isn't really a bling person. She's more of the earthy vintage look. But of course, since it's something I'm making for her, I have to put a little bit of myself in there. So for me, it's the bling. So I just added a little bit to the front to give it that extra sparkle. Alrighty, I think that's it. If you have any questions, leave me a comment below and I will get back to you as soon as I can. I believe I went over everything. If I didn't, just leave a comment, ask the question, and I'll be happy to answer it. Alrighty, and you can probably hear my kids screaming in the background, so sorry about that. I'm out of here. Thanks so much for watching. Bye.